الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين، سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هو الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وجعل منها زوجها ليسكن إليها. صدق الله مولانا العلي العظيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم صلاة وسلاما عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، صلاة وسلاما عليك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله، صلاة وسلاما عليك يا رحمة للعالمين، وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا شفيع المذنبين صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And inshallah, we will continue with the story of Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And yesterday we very briefly touched upon the khilafat of Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to the malaika, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he intends to send a khalifa to the dunya. And the ulama, they have also explained that every single rasul, every single nabi, they are all a khulafa. They are all people who have been sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as khulafa. It is not only Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And with regards to Sayyiduna Dawood alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he also said that we have sent Dawood alayhi salatu wasalam as a khalifa. So khilafat is not only for Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And yesterday we also spoke about the shaitan disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala ask him to leave the courtyard of the malaika when he refused to perform sajda of ta'zim for Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Now after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had asked him to spend some time in Jannah. According to some riwayah, it is said that for 40 days Adam alayhi salatu wasalam spent in Jannah. Some scholars have given different other numbers, different months, different weeks, different days he spent in Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he had other things planned for Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, stay in Jannah, live in Jannah, eat and drink whatever you want from Jannah. So Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he was enjoying life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him. And as you can imagine, life in Jannah is nothing compared to the life of this dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one day he made Adam alayhi salatu wasalam sleep. And when Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he woke up from his sleep, he saw a beautiful creation sitting by his head. So Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he was shocked to see that a creation that resembles him with very minor difference, but it is in the form of clay and water, just like the creation of Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, at that moment, he was very amazed, and at the same time he was shocked. And Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he asked, you know, who are you? And this creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied and said, Mar'a, I am a woman. Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he continued and he said that, why were you created? And this creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so that you can find sukoon and comfort in me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in Surah Al-A'raf, verse 189, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he says, هو الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وجعل منها زوجها ليسكن إليها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, هو الذي خلقكم. It is he who created you from a single soul, من نفس واحدة. وجعل منها زوجها, and from him made its mate for him to gain comfort with her, to gain sukoon with her. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the other creation for Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And later on, the malaika, they came to Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and said to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, you know, what is this next to you? Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, al-mar'a, he said, she's a woman. The malaika, they asked Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, what was her name? And Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he replied instantly and he said, her name is Hawa. Hawa, it comes from the word hay. Hay means life. The reason why Adam alayhi salatu wasalam called Sayyidatuna Hawa alayhi salam Hawa, because Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha, she was created from Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, who himself, he was a living creature of Allah subhanahu, a living creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was already a living human being. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha from Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, and not from like asking the malaika to bring some mitti, some clay, some soil so that he can create Adam Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha. Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha, she was actually created from the rib of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, and it is, and this is also proven from the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam, reported by Ibn Hibban, that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Adam alayhi salatu wasalam to have sukoon, to have comfort in Hawa radiyallahu ta'ala anha, because Hawa radiyallahu ta'ala anha, she was part of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha, and the reason for creating a female, a soulmate for Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he says, وَجَعَلَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا لِيَسْكُنَ إِلَيْهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made her زَوْجَهَا. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala made them husband and wife, لِيَسْكُنَ إِلَيْهَا, so that Adam can live with Hazrat Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha. And the goal of nikah, the goal of living with your partner, with somebody you have married to, is so that we can have sukoon in our life, so that we can have comfort in our life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here, he is also making it very clear that at the beginning of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he mentioned zawjaha. And the only way you can become zawjun or zawjatun to one another is through the door of nikah. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, according to some riwayat, the ulama have also mentioned this in the tafasir, according to these riwayat, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala asked Adam alayhi salatu wasalam to do nikah with Sayyidatuna Hawar alayha salam. And the way the nikah was conducted is that Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he had to give a mahar to Sayyidatuna Hawa alayha salam. And the mahar at that time was not in terms of money. The mahar was not in terms of car, houses, or whatever expensive, valuable things it is. But the mahar for Sayyidatuna Adam alayhi salatu wasalam at that time was to read darood upon the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasalam. This was the mahar of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam to Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha. So to read darood and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasalam. Now Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, the Jannah that Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was staying, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha that you can also remain in the same Jannah. Now the ulama, they say, what type of Jannah was it? Because if it was a permanent Jannah, Adam and Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha, they would have always remained in that Jannah. But some scholars, they said that this Jannah was not the Jannah which is called Jannatul Khuld, or the Jannah of eternity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He had created a different type of Jannah so that Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha, they could live together. Because some scholars, they have said that once you enter Jannah, you cannot come out of Jannah. Once you enter Jannah, you cannot come out of Jannah. And as for Iblis, he was also in a type of Jannah. But Iblis was removed from that Jannah when he disobeyed the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Jannah that Adam and Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, they were staying, was not a permanent Jannah. It's not the Jannah which we call Jannatul Khuld, but it was a temporary Jannah which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created for them at that time. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam and Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha, and said to them, وَلَا تَقَرَبَا هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةَ فَتَكُونَا مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Adam and Hawa radiallahu ta'ala anha, وَلَا تَقَرَبَا هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةَ. Do not go near this tree. And this was a direct hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this tree that we are talking about here, there are different riwayah. According to some riwayah, it is said that the tree was a tree of zaytun. It was an olive tree. According to other scholars, they said that it was a tree of barley. According to other scholars, they said that it was made of grapes. It was a tree of grapes. But the ulama, they said, look, whatever type of tree, whatever type of fruit it was, it doesn't matter which one it is. The main thing here was that Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he was asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to go very close to that tree. And the Quran also did not mention, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala did not mention what kind of tree it was. So certainly it was not an apple tree. Certainly it was not an apple tree. It was different types of fruit which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Adam alayhi salatu wasalam not to go close to. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَا تَقْرَبَ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةَ فَتَكُونَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. That, O Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, do not go near that tree. Both of you should not go near that tree. And this was a particular tree which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us tawfiq that when we live our life, or the youngsters who are performing nikah today, they should be performing nikah with the intention of seeking sukoon from, you know, the person they are doing nikah to. Not seeking sukoon with friends outside, not seeking sukoon with something other than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for you. And this is where we see many problems in our lives, in our nikah. This is why we, you know, after a nikah has taken place 6 months later or a year later, or maybe in some cases lesser than that, you see people coming to us because they haven't understood the importance of nikah. They haven't understood the importance of liyaskunu ilayha. So this is very, very important that before we perform our nikah, before we perform our marriage, it is important that we learn our deen, the deen which Allah and His Messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has chosen for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us tawfiq. Wa akhiru da'awana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.